let's paint our blue gate now. I'm using a mixture of phthalo blue plus white. This just makes a really nice color that's perfect for the Santa Fe little gates and stuff. And I'm going to paint in my light and dark pattern. Shadows. I'll let this shadow extend down. Because again, the light's coming in from the upper right, so this building will cast a shadow. That wall will cast a shadow on the gate as well as this beam up above. I think that beam is called a lintel, but I'm not absolutely positive. I'm pretty sure that's what it is though. So I'm gonna let this wall, I'm gonna let the shadow extend out beyond this wall back here so that doesn't all just line up. I have a tendency to make everything line up, just I have to work real hard not to. Jack said I could paint a line of paintings in a painting and they would all be just perfectly spaced like fence posts. I have to work real hard not to do that. Now the geranium, and this is going to cast, that shadow is going to cast over here behind that chair, which is good because that'll help the light then hitting that yellow bench will pop because of this dark behind it. We'll get a little dark back there. Now I clean out my brush with thinner and I wipe it out with tissue paper. So I'm going to start my lighter color now. So I want my brush to be clean. I don't want any of that dark color to make my light part darker. Then this is that same mixture but with just more white in it. I don't mind if there's a little variation in it. These old gates are weathered and they're not just perfectly the same color all the way. That's some of the charm just of these old gates. Get a little smaller brush to do that in and around the arm of the bench there. Make sure it's clean. Okay. I just work carefully around that arm. I want to keep my drawing. Don't want to lose that. By having the chair break out in front of the doorway, that helps give the feeling of depth in the painting. Overlapping objects is a good way to give that feeling of depth. Again, I'm going to let those boards, some of the color be a little uneven, like the wood over time is aged and weathered. Let some of the light pop through these leaf shadows. I just drag those into the wet paint. That softens the edges. Now I take some of my wall color. I've saved my paint from the walls. So I can just make this edge. I'm going to brace on my mall stick. This is my mall stick and it just hooks over the top of my easel. I can brace on that and steady my hand as I pull this line down. That's Molly. She wants to go outside, but she's just going to have to wait till we're finished here. That gives me a good straight line. And again, I just take some of my lighter color and pull up a little bit into that, the shadow. Just give that feeling of the old weathered wood. I soften that edge of the shadow, I can just drag my brush over that edge, and that softens that edge. Okay, now I want to pull the lines separating the boards. And I use my lighter mixture here. And I just, again, like I did on the grill in the window, I make little reference points. So this helps me to get my boards even. Gives me a starting point, because I don't want a line going right on the edge of that shadow, so that's why I develop those. And it doesn't matter if these are not perfectly straight, those are old weathered boards and they twist a little bit and warp. And so it doesn't matter if they're not totally straight. Thank goodness, because I don't think I could make them totally straight. That's one thing about painting Santa Fe architecture. There's nothing that's straight. That rounded adobe is curves and makes it fun to paint. Now I'm using on the highlights, then I'm using that same mix with a little more white in it. And the sun catches just the edge of those boards. My little darker mixture. It's right there. All right. Now on the top edge of the gate, we'll also have a little bit of a highlight on that. It's in shadow, so we don't want that to be real bright. But again, the top of that gate gets a little bit of a edge on it. Now for the hinges. I'm using my mud plus liquid, and the mud again is the ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson. And I brace on my mall stick and I pull my line horizontally. And I can use my board lines as reference points. So I want to come out that same distance on this hinge down here. It doesn't matter if it pulls up a little of the paint underneath. Okay. Now we're going to make those curlicues. Again, I use my boards as a reference point so that I can make the two hinges similar. They're not going to be identical, but they'll be similar. And in these wrought iron hinges, they're not always the same anyway. Similar. It's a good word. Got that one. And I come here. And this one's going to come out a little further. And again, I pick up some of that paint, but that doesn't really matter. It gives a little variation in that hinge color. This is one time when I don't mind picking up that paint underneath. But make my curlicue. And you can see that mimics the same thing that we have in the grill on the window. Now I know I can just bring this one out to the center there. And these two will be very similar. Little bit weird on the bottom. All I have to do is come back and just pull up some of that with my shadow color. Now we're going to make the door latch. And I'm using a little bit smaller brush now. This is a number 4. And again, that's a bright brush. The other one was a number 6 that I used up here. I just pull that into the wet paint. Now it's going to extend past the door because, or the gate, because that actually goes into an opening there on the side of the wall there. Now I'm going to use a little, the larger brush again. I can find the right one. Here it is. Make sure this is clean. I'm going to pull this latch down. Since it's in, the latch is more toward the wall. It's probably a little bit wide, but I can come back and narrow it. Some of my paint from the gate. And then there's a couple little brackets that hold this. We'll see the edge of this just a little bit. And there will be a highlight there. I'm going to use just a tiny bit of white plus ultramarine blue. Just highlight that. This part comes up here. That loops up. And then this edge is going to get a little highlight on it. The brackets are also, the light catches them. That may be a little bright because this is in the shade, but I can go back. And then now this tip of the latch, it's catching the sunlight. So it's going to catch a real bright highlight there. And then it's going to cast a shadow on the gate. So I take some of my darker shadow color, and the light's coming from the right, I just pull that down like that. And that gives me my shadow. Now I'll also highlight these edges on the hinges. Light's coming in from the right, so this edge gets highlighted. Hinges and things are fun to do. They're just little details that really make this feel Southwestern. And for Santa Fe, we found that by giving them paintings that are Santa Fe, have the Santa Fe flavor, people like to take that home with them. They come to Santa Fe for a visit and they like to take home a memory of Santa Fe. So that's one of the reasons why I do a lot of Santa Fe paintings for Santa Fe. We're in a tourist area, and people like to take a little bit of that touch of their vacation home. They can look at it and recapture the memories. Now here I'm using a little bit of the color from my beams up here, just to kind of get a feeling of a little rust on those hinges. This is going to, since this is catching the light, there's going to be a shadow underneath it. And that's going to catch a little light right in there. Now I'm going to brace my hand on the canvas that's not painted here to do this. go. That's just catching a little bit of the light there. Let me put one little highlight here. There. Now I'm going to give a little bit of a rusty feel to this latch. Doesn't have to be much, just a few brush strokes, and by pulling into that wet of the blue paint, it just gives a nice little touch. Do a little bit right here on the hand, this little cross part of the latch. This little, I'm going to catch just a little light here too. Won't be too much. So, there's our hinges and latch on the gate. Thank you for watching my YouTube videos. Please subscribe to my channel. And if you'd like to see the step-by-step process of this painting, the entire process, please visit my blog, www.mickysenkerik.wordpress.com. The address is in the description below my video. It's also on the final frame. You have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful day. And thank you. Also, please feel free to ask questions if you'd like. So I'm here to help other artists. So you have a great day.